Civilization 6, and our game is the Swahili. Let's go ahead and jump into it. By advancing to our next turn, so right now, I think we need to get a builder or two out, because I know that we have some sea resources that are not improved. We also have to get a couple more Jazzies out and about to finish off our getting all of our fishing boats and sea features adjacent to a Jazzy. Okay, World Congress banned the production of buildings of this type, or 50% discount on the production of buildings of this type. It's a global energy treaty. We also have a border control treaty. Well, I'll go ahead and upvote the World's Fair. And then, I don't really have a preference about any of these. So I'll vote for, myself. Throw a few points into that, and then 50% discount. I'll try to ban coal power plants, because I already have all my coal power plants. I don't really care how any of these votes go, to be honest. Nothing here that's too important to me. Sydney Opera House.
Long after it's come down. It starts in my imagination, it becomes my life, and it stays part of my life long after I've left the Opera House.
Gorgeous. Okay, so it looks like we won banning coal power plants and voting for points. So that's simple enough. We also, speaking of which, got a great person. Okay, so now we have to decide if we want to take Stamford Raffles or not. He will give us another city, because he absorbs the city-state into our empire. And listen, I think he's a great, I mean, he's literally a great merchant. It's a silly thing to say, but, oh, that's interesting. Faces as a settler running around, which they can't use, of course, because they are a city-state. But, yeah, there's just not really a, tiles yield plus one production if adjacent to another forest tile. Lumber mills yield plus two coals when adjacent to a river. Well, that is nice. But also we're not really the type of game that we got here. We don't have a lot of forest or lumber mills. We'll go ahead and put this Jazzy to sleep. Trader here that we will set to gold. And if I thought Constantinople was hard to pronounce, Mikasiwashik. Yeah. Of course, ASMR grants 10% production towards buildings and some stuff with steel, but we already have steel. Alexander Pushkin has written Boris Godunov. And Samarkand keeps slipping away from us. They are very good. Oh wow, Poundmaker really just decided to put all of his envoys into a mouth. I don't like that. I mean, here's the thing, right? We could just go take Samarkand. Because honestly, at this point, yeah, you know what? That's the move. That's the move. We're grabbing Mr. Stamford Raffles. And we are sending him down to, why can't I absorb? Must be in the territory of a city-state of which you are suzerain. Okay, well that's good to know. Okay. I was hoping to just take, I mean, I guess we could go grab Katna for Old Faithful. Again, not a great one for us, honestly. But it would let us make a national park there for a bit more tourism. I don't know. I think honestly, we are still gonna go for Samarkand. We'll just have to get them back with envoys first. Okay. We should check our quick deals. We also have a lot of money and should use that for something. Jalousies, probably, would be good. Especially if there are, sea resources. Like right here, we need a jalousy right here. Because, our sea resources, or not resources, features, are going to give us due culture. And, that culture is translated into tourism at this point in the game. Because we researched environmentalism, I think. Okay, we're out of coal. Which isn't great. I like that we can build a bridge. It's a very funny little mod. I have a friend who we play online occasionally, and he loves he's gonna Theater Square, not a big deal. He loves the bridges for some reason. So to make our his dreams of having bridges a reality, I have that mod downloaded. Will you sell me coal? Because I can use some coal. Yeah, that's fine. Quick deals. Let's see what we can hog some of our resources here. Says that we have extra olives, but also doesn't show olives as a luxury here, so that makes me suspicious. I'm gonna take olives off the table. Because I don't trust it. I don't want to lose my olives, you know. Who wants to lose their olives? Everybody loves olives. Okay. We'll buy a jahazi here. Another great merchant, which will give us us a little infusion of gold. I don't really care about that at the moment. Also means I should get rid of my destroyer. Whatever this is, I think this uses oil, right? Oh no, we're only using oil for power. Okay. We'll just go for, I don't know, it doesn't really much matter, does it? At this point, we've kind of secured our culture, technologies. Great Admiral David Farragut. So, that's fine. Strahasi goes to bed for their eternal slumber. And okay, I need to find, I don't know if you're using power, but I know that I have an ironclad somewhere. And unfortunately we gotta sink that brave ship. My beloved Medusa, sink it to the bottom of the ocean. Send it to Davy Jones' locker. Now, we still have a unit that's using power. Or using coal. And I'm not sure who it is. Probably this guy. The Lady Anne. I wish I would tell you. It probably does. I just don't exactly know where. Alright. So we could buy another district here. Question is, which district? And we'll do a water park. We can get another district as well. I mean, I could turn that down, except for the fact that it would crush our spot that's giving us tourism, so I won't be doing that. We'll go ahead and buy some of these buildings because we got the money, and these buildings give tourism, and then we're going to launch the moon landing, or at least we're going to begin the process of launching the moon landing. And then we will promote Bengala, not because we even have him in the place where we're doing space projects, but because we have that governor that gives us extra money for promoted governors. Or not the governor, the merchant, the great merchant. Gustav Eiffel. I don't think we're building any wonders at the moment, are we? What's Gilmore doing? Can you build any wonders? Not a single wonder. Not a single wonder. Okay. Well then, I guess carry on. That's fine. Saint-Michel. Go build this. And then Gustav Eiffel can go over there and build it. We all recall, of course, that Gustav Eiffel was famous for building a revered French landmark. And that construction is, of course, the Mont Saint-Michel. We got a little whale over there. I gotta get more builders ASAP. I forgot to buy a little horde of them because we need to, we need builders to start getting ski resorts. Ski resorts bring in tourism.
False actions speak louder than words. A good plan violently executed right now is far better than a perfect plan executed next week.
Okay. So, can I thank you? Yes, I can. Okay, I think that was using one. Interesting. Anybody else got coal? Wants to sell it to us? Well, I took all your coal. 73 gold per turn. That's fine. Honestly, it's a lot of money, but we're making a lot of money. Like, a lot of money. Okay. We can get Broadway. So we'll start trying to get Broadway. We can get Kotoku in. It's all about the wonders, remember? Everything is about the wonders. I'm just buying buildings because, you know, we got the money, and, wow, builders are dirt cheap. We have a mountain over here. We will not have a single natural mountain left in our territory, this I swear. Everything will become a monument to the ski gods. I'm gonna take a sip of my tea and hope it doesn't scald my mouth. No, it's perfect. Should do is convert some of our coal factories to oil refineries, because we have a positive intake of oil and a negative intake of coal. We're getting 7 coal per turn. We're getting 3 oil per turn, and that'll soon be 5 oil per turn, I think. I think that's how much you get from improving as strategic. Okay. A boom. Mr. Gustav can nearly instantly build the Mont Saint-Michel. This builder can go there and build a solar. Stanford Raffles will go to sleep while we figure out what to do with him. Get an oil well. Now we have a bunch of envoys to send. And can we take Samarkand? Yes, we can. And when I say take Samarkand, I mean it. Very literally, because we are taking Samarkand. It belongs to us now. Well, now it belongs to us. Oh, look at that. I thought that I was sending my... okay. I don't know what, where I'll have to cut there. My dogs just started barking, so I had to go take care of them. Ominously said, "What Sidon do? Plus one movement for all civilian units. Do not care, didn't ask." Okay. The Lone Star. Yeah, I thought I was sending the Lone Star in to just get killed on all of those barbarian units, but man, there's a lot of city-state settlers that if I was interested in expanding my borders right now, I could easily just sweep them up. Samarkand. I think might as well just start building a wonder. So we'll do exactly that. We'll also buy a builder. We'll also buy a trader. We'll also buy a shipyard. We'll also buy a seaport. And we'll also buy a sewer. The sewer was unnecessary, gilding the lily a bit there, because we only have 9 out of 17 housing. We should also get a Jahazi, but I think they're out of our price range. Yeah, they're getting pretty expensive. Governor Amani is no longer assigned to Samarkand, because I conquered it. Yo, you'll give me an epic for this stuff. Yeah, take it, by all means. tourism for me. It's great. Cheese. Samarkand, the land of luxury. You know, I didn't really think about this game because, I just didn't think about it, I guess. Music. So I want to integrate that. By the way, this is actually from the same friend who I downloaded the Bridges mod to play with. He gets mad whenever this quote is said. NASA spent millions of dollars inventing the ballpoint pen so they could write in space. The Russians took a pencil. Because he's like in aerospace stuff. Studied it, and so he was like, the graphite bits in pencils that are released as you write are gonna float around in the spaceship and can cause problems. So he gets annoyed whenever that example is used as an example of like over. I don't even know what to call it, like over scientifically. Oh, just overworking, you know, working harder, not smarter, right? Because he's like, no, actually, it was important. Yeah, we'll put a solar farm there, why not? Get some gold. This builder some pomegranates. And then we have another great engineer. And we have Alan Turing, who is useless to us. We have all of those technologies already. So we will pass on Mr. Turing. Great work on the Enigma code or whatever. Still nothing to really do here, except I suppose trade some coffee so we can make some coffee products and ship them around our empire. So let's take a water park down. Followed by a commercial hub, I guess. Oh, that's a volcano. A mountain, and I was like, hey, we gotta go put a ski resort on that, but I guess people don't want to ski on the slopes of Mount St. Helens. Siam is giving us some trouble. close to getting a rock band, yeah. We probably already have them, don't we? Maybe not. Church and state, soul and body. Ah, look at that. Mont Saint-Michel. Do that. Build me the Golden Gate Bridge and destroy this gorgeous boulder, but it must be done for the sake of the wonder. I don't suppose you can build it on a lake. No. Okay. That's fine. We'll get rid of the boulder. Tourism from national parks and improvements in the city. Trade routes traveling through can multiply gold. And now we're trying to build it. Definitely not an optimal placement for it. Actually, just gonna buy the stadium for the sake of getting the tourism. Flowing. And just build a gilded vault and then a sewer and a couple of the theater square festivals. Out here, don't we? Because that's a reef. So, go there. We'll just buy a Jazzy here. We have the money for it now. Send it over to this reef. Joseph Paxton gives this entertainment complex buildings plus one amenity, and the reach of the buildings is 3 tiles greater. And of course we can do that twice because of what is possibly the best wonder in the game, the Mausoleum at Halicarnassus. You know, but I would say that I think the mausoleum has got to be near the top of that list, if not number one. Yeah, we're currently skyrocketing towards a culture victory. Has 9 turns right now. We'll see if that turns out to be shorter or longer. Siam could pull some tricks. Try to prevent us from pulling that off. This builder. this builder can do something for me, presumably. Yeah, that needs a fishing boat. Another instance of lobster. Oh, we could create another corporation. So we should get a great merchant to do that for us. And we'll just go ahead and buy one. Which, of course, has only been getting cheaper and cheaper with every wonder that we build on the coast. I gotta say, having gone through a game with the Swahili now, I think that they're super fun. It's fun too. I mean, just right off the bat, I love building wonders, even, you know, in general, even before I played in this game. I just love building wonders in this game. It's one of the, you know, one of the top ways that I sort of have fun in the game. You know, I love, like, maximizing tile yields and building wonders that, like, scratches the little itch in my brain for those things. Look at this. So we got a bunch of warrior monks, which we don't care about. So we'll just get rid of them. But I did send one down to a tribal village just to see if he could pick it up. Solomon R. Guggenheim. Now, I'm not an expert on my great industrialists of history, but I think Solomon R. Guggenheim was on the Titanic. I'm probably wrong about that. But hey, I might be right. We'll buy the aquarium and the aquatic center because, again, these buildings give us tourism. Just make us feel sweet. Feel all sugary sweet inside. Oh, we should get a Jazzy down here in Samarkand. By the Jahazi, Pavlos Kontoriotis will give us a governor title. We'll activate you. We still can't get master plan, huh? Locked in atomic era. Okay. We should assign you somewhere. Okay. And then sold the olives that I said I shouldn't sell. Oh well. Not a big deal. I have a lot of amenities. I think. Anyway. Let's... Oh yeah, plus 19 amenities in my capital. I mean, come on. My capital needs more housing. Plus 18 here. Plus 19 here. Plus 18. I mean, yeah, my people are happy as can be. I'm making life good for them. Making life real good for them. History by learning about globalization.
No boundaries, no flags, no countries, and your own passports with a heart.
Okay. I'll refrain from making political commentary about globalization. It's you know, it's sort of the thing about games like this, right? These, what do they call them? 4X games? Exploration, expansion, extermination. It's probably one of them, I don't know. Proficient. Ooh, I like industry list. Anyway, it's sort of the gamifying of, like, bad things, and I'm not trying to... No, okay, Guggenheim, activate. And I don't want to put globalization on the... I don't want to rank bad things right now, and I don't even want to say globalization is all bad. Just like anything, there's pros and cons, right? Well, not anything. I'm getting into this, and I don't want to. This is not, a relaxing topic. Stop here. Yeah, things are coming along very nicely for us. We're about to get environmentalism, which will give us a plus 25% tourism boost. So that'll help us cross the finish line. Yeah, because Siam is giving us trouble. They've pushed us away from cultural victory. So we're gonna need to deal with that, aren't we?
There may be no forgiveness.
New great person. I will be buying the services of Helena Rubinstein. Some buildings here. Get the Ferris wheel. Get the aquarium. Get the aquatics center. Get the market. Get the gilded vault. And then build the stock exchange because we don't have enough money to buy it. And now we have a free builder here who's finished improving these luxuries. So go ahead and a little solar farm. Actually, build a moe. You go to sleep. Let's renew our alliances. Will you give us gold? To you. How cruel. Empire so I can get more great works. I'll buy a trader. And I'll maybe buy another trader if I have enough money. I do. I need to go look up what those Moe do, because I know that they give tourism. I think it's Rapa Nui that gives them. Yeah. Plus one culture for every two adjacent Moe, plus two culture of on or adjacent to a volcanic soil tile, plus one culture of adjacent to a coast or lake tile. Okay. Okay. So you want to stack them up, get a bunch of them together. Samarkand with a Moe. Cover the island with them. The Canterbury Tales. I will make this deal even though I'm running out of coal. Because anything that will give me tourism is a good thing. Like I must have gotten rock band by now and I just didn't recognize it or realize it. I think they come with like Cold War or something, I forget. But regardless, I should really be pumping out rock bands. Yeah, I gotta say, one thing I don't love about like the sort of end game of Civ sometimes. The end game kind of always comes out the same, is it's like, okay, what are you doing if you, go for a domination victory? Well, you're sending units out to other civilizations, cities, and, where's, there you are. You're sending units out to other cities to take them over. What do you do if you win a religion victory? Well, you're sending units out to other cities to convert them. What are you doing if you're winning a culture victory? Well, you're sending units out to other cities to, perform there. And, it's basically the same thing, you know? I mean, I shouldn't say that. I shouldn't say that, domination, like conquering a city, is the same as taking it over religiously, although it's kind of similar because you can still, you do a lot of religious combat, which is, essentially the same thing as domination, just, slightly different set of mechanics. And then tourism is like the most boring one of all. You just send your rock bands out to other empires and have them perform, and it's just like random chance, like, oh, cool, I lost that rock band. Oh, cool, that one did really well. I think the civilization endgame is not great, in my personal opinion. You know, it's the thing, it's sort of like, the dramatic question, right? In like story writing and stuff. You ask yourself, like, neurologically unsafe instant coffee. Okay, well, I probably shouldn't be drinking that. I have a couple, things here that I didn't turn into, ski resorts. Still can't get Mr. Chopin. But next turn, I can. tourism system is kind of obscure to me. I don't really understand, like, I mean, I understand that, the broad strokes is, are generate tourism and get tourists from other countries to come to yours and keep your own tourists in your own country. But I don't understand the actual mechanical implementation of it. It's like too complicated for me to bother with. Or at least that's the impression I have. Coastal flooding has happened. We should probably make sure Samarkand isn't subject to coastal flooding. Okay. Can you not go because you haven't promoted yet? Is that why? This is the important thing to do, and we don't have nearly enough faith generation to even, like, sustain this for a while, so we'll just use up all of our faith. We'll get a neighborhood, because again, a neighborhood will let us get, another market or whatever. Civilization. I mean, come on, we'll let you premiere your work in the Sydney Opera House. Can't do better than that, can you? Considering I'm playing with the Monopolies and Corporations mode on, I probably, a tourism game with that game mode on is substantially different. Well, not substantially different, but it just has a different facet, which is you should really make a beeline for luxury resources. Like, if I were being optimal, smart about it, I'd send out a couple settlers down here to scoop up all these luxuries. Try to get myself more of a monopoly, because you get big tourism bonuses from that. And frankly, oh, look at that. Moon landing generates a one-time culture bonus equal to 10 times your science per turn. Charo. Just retire immediately. Frederick Chopin. Make your music. Beautiful Nocturne in E flat major. Who doesn't love it? It's a classic. Literally classical. Are you gonna make a friendship with me? No, you're not. Very rude of you. Very, very rude. Astra. Which will give us a bit more food in our cities with holy sites. Any good ones that we should take back? Oh yeah, amenities. Kadohoyuk, come back home to us. We lost Katarakama, so we'll take them back. And then, guess that's that. Dump one into Sidon. Governor Dynal. This builder should go there. This rock band will promote. Why can't I go and perform in your cities? Huh? Have you done that thing where? Wait, what? It does not want to show me. Needs a name. Okay, yeah, that's fine. Bro, really, that's very silly. Okay. Yep, that was it. They just wanted a name. Okay. Now our rock bands can take to the seas. Named because Sid Meier's said, "Nah, bro, you're not allowed to, have your rock band perform unless you type in a name." So anyway, I mean, we're in the end game now. Just about finishing it off. I'm finishing it off strong. Yeah, you know, I put a lot of hours into Civ. I love it. I think it's a great franchise. But you know, there's just the problem of the end game, and at a certain point, things just become like it a slog. And you know, I don't know exactly how to go about fixing that. Some ideas, I guess, right? Like alternate. No business like show business. Oh, look at that, Broadway. You know, like alternate, like adding new victory conditions that aren't. You know, it's not like I have to take. If I'm going for a domination victory, I have to take over the entire world to win. Okay, we'll put in online communities for a little bit more tourism. We'll swap out laissez-faire. Mr. Chopin needs a place to put his new work, and he'll put it in Broadway. Remember when Chopin premiered Valse Brillante at downtown New York? Hippolyta removed from the game so I say it all the time. Whenever I'm like playing with a friend, I make that joke. It's a bad joke, but I do it repeatedly. It's like funny the first time. Okay. Yeah, just make some lobsters. My people demand lobster rolls. Send it to the same city. Medieval, Renaissance. Do I have another medieval relic somewhere? I do. Wow, I could have been producing all this extra tourism. If I had just... Oh, how silly of me. I had two things that I could have had themed this entire time. What's done is done. I'm just promoting governors at random at this point to, you know, get, okay. We just gotta get these, rock bands on the move. Tribal village. And hey, honestly, not a bad thing to get because we are having, we're at negative oil. What are they? A little fleet of Byzantium Navy backing up my, my poor little privateer. Have you guys ever had the Bermuda Triangle close enough that you could reach these tiles? I've always wanted to get a game where I could settle a city within reach of the Bermuda Triangle, but I've never seen it close enough. Well, I am out of tea. Almost 1100 culture per turn. The next highest is 258. It's unbelievable. So here's our top tier digital democracy. To keep our really good trade routes going. And then I think extra culture, holy cats, plus 5 culture for every city state you are the suzerain of gives us an extra 900 culture. Closing in on the end of Dragon Age Inquisition. I got through one of the DLCs. I have basically just one more to go, and then I'm going to trigger the end game. And then there is another DLC that's sort of an epilogue. Maybe not an epilogue, just it can only be triggered after the... after you beat the game. Whereas the other before you beat the game. Let's buy this. And, oh, we don't have any money. I've blown through my coffers. Get a research lab, a broadcast center, and theater square festivals. Like, okay, yes, I know every city. I want to have all the little buildings in all the little districts. Like, at a certain point, I just want to turn on, click a button that says, would you like us to auto-build every available building in every available district, you know? And it's like, yeah, you know, if you need me to place a district, I'll do that. Like, I want to decide where things are placed in my empires, but... You know, let me click on a builder and just select auto improve, where they'll go to, like, the nearest, tile that's being worked and improve it, right? Stuff like that. To just make it a little less, like, monotonous. You're not in the... Go there. Another great person. Sarah Breedlove gives us more tourism. Melita Bence also does, so we should buy her immediately. Frida Kahlo. You can go there to put your great works of art. This builder. The magic conch has served me well, and good night to the magic conch, because I don't want to deal with you anymore. We're close. We are very, very close. We might even seal the deal before our rock bands get into place. Oh no, our rock bands are in place, so we'll seal the deal this turn, probably. Super cool, just like losing all these rock bands randomly. Also, in a game that otherwise has fairly appealing sound design, the rock bands are super annoying. It's like, I have a horde of rock bands that I have to activate, and every time they play the same metal riff, and it's just like, it's not easy on the ears when you hear it for the 50th time on the same turn. Very negative this video. I apologize for that. Again, you know, I put a lot of hours into Civ 6. I do think it's a fun game. It's just sometimes when you play something for that long, and I will also say I'm on the downswing from this game. Like, you know, I've said in the past in the videos that I've made when I've been playing Civ, like, oh, I haven't played in a while, and the reason is because I just don't, you know, it's lost the allure for me. I just don't really have too much fun with it anymore. But look at this, St. Basil's Cathedral. Gorgeous. just start building the Hermitage. And you build a stock exchange and then do some more theater square festivals. And then you, I'll buy a shopping mall for you. And then theater square festival. Sarah Breedlove for extra tourism. Although, I guess the issue is I don't think I actually have a trade route to Siam, so it's not really going to help me. Start building the stadium. Oops, that's not what I meant to do. Oops, again, I keep on wanting to delete this unit apparently. And our rock bands left and right. Do you have any wonders around here? There, go perform in the great baths. Alright, come on. This turn, come on. Own called Major Snake. I'd like to see Major Snake outperform Mute Map and Loyal Fire and Unknown Beats. Somebody stole the Golden Gate Bridge from me. I will destroy them. Come on, give me the tourism victory. Give it to me. I'm ready for it. Look at Poland down here. Building the Panama Canal down here in Warsaw. On their gorgeous snow tiles here. Really great territory Poland got this game. Boy, long loading this time. I guess all the coastal flooding is happening. Ay, ay, ay. Okay, we have not done what we set out to do yet. Not quite there. 4,000 tourism. $750. Come on. Sir Arthur Conan Doyle. Okay. Research lab. Let's put a pathetic little bridge there. Because in a sort of memoriam to our beloved Golden Gate Bridge that we lost. We lost Mute Map. Tragic. Okay. Come on, dude. How's the culture going? Well, we're currently 13. So I guess we just need to let Siam's turn happen to see if he can overturn that. Ah, look at this.
The worth of a culture is not measured by its accomplishments. How those accomplishments last and how they are remembered. The beauty that you have inspired our people to create. Sure.
Nelson Mandela, real leaders must be ready to sacrifice all for the freedom of their people. Well, not much war this game. It was basically us, nobody else, except for Poundmaker, Captured City, looks like. Great people earned, yeah. I mean, the whole point of this Civ is like build wonders and make it cheaper to hire great people. So that graph makes sense. Wonders constructed. Let's take a look at that. Yeah. Okay. Well. Anyway. Go back and take in the beauty of what's this guy's name? Suleiman. Alassane ibn Suleiman. So thank you for watching. I do kind of like doing the Civ series videos, but also in sort of like the last couple of videos, they get, I don't like playing to the end game of Civ, but because I'm doing it for the videos, I feel like, I should stick to the end. I should just get to the end so that it's one complete thing. But honestly, it's like when I play by myself or with my friend, we never make it to the end of a game, because it's like, you know, at a certain point, I think I was talking about this earlier and then I got distracted, but it's like the dramatic question in storytelling, which is, you know, what's the dramatic question of a scene? What's the question that the audience is interested in finding out the answer to? And you have their interest until you give them the answer. Once the question is answered, then you move on. The scene is done, right? And so, you know, my problem with Civ is that from a gameplay, I think that that's a useful thing to think about games as well, is like, keep the player engaged until the dramatic question is answered, and then you move on to the next thing, you know? Because that's how you get bored players. And so my kind of fundamental critique about Civ is that the game persists for literally hours after the dramatic question is answered. And it's rare that you have a nail-biter ending, you know, a close finish ending. So, you know, but hey, still a fun game. Maybe I'll do some scenarios or something instead. I mean, I'll still probably come back to this game and play a game, but I'll probably do a smaller map, you know, more like the Persia game that I did. Because I knocked that one out in two videos. But this game has some fun scenarios. Like, there's one where you're settling Australia, and there's one where you play as Poland, and there's one where you play as Alexander the Great. I mean, you can play as those civs in the game, obviously, but, like, the scenarios, if you're unfamiliar, are particular setups. So in the Australia one, you play on a big map of Australia, right? So I'm thinking about that, but take a little break from Civ for a bit anyways. So whatever comes next, I'm not sure what I'll do next. I know I need to go back to FDL at some point, because I still have to keep my promise to